What's up, YouTube? So today I want to talk to you guys about Little Snitch. Little Snitch is a network monitoring tool or firewall for macOS. And in my opinion, it is definitely the best firewall you can get for macOS. It's available here on their website. You can grab the latest version, and the nightly version is also working for macOS Sierra. So if you guys are on the latest beta, this program will also work for you. You can purchase a full license from their website. Right now, you can get it for $36.90, which includes Micro Snitch, which is a camera and microphone monitoring tool as well. So, just to take a look here at Little Snitch. So, we begin in the taskbar here with the network monitoring tool. This appears when you hover over and shows all the connections that are currently running. You can select individually per connection. If you right-click, you can also open up the general settings here. As well, if you go back in here, you can right-click and open up the rules, which are set for the firewall. So in your settings here, you can actually turn the firewall network filter on or off just by tapping the start filter on and off. Alerts are the alerts you get when you're prompted from an application to access the internet, usually shown when the application first launches. Once it's added to the rules in your firewall list, it doesn't appear again. So if we clear the rule for Google Chrome and we go to launch Google Chrome, you'll see here we're getting the alert that the settings was here in Little Snitch. So with this, you can actually customize which connections it makes, how long that connection lasts. So if you want it to last until you reboot, you can also get full details of the connection right here, so you can see everything about that connection. If we hit apply, we'll be able to access the internet just like that. Now, if you hover back over, you can see the connection beginning to download as the video begins to play, which you can use the monitoring tool to monitor the connection in and out of your system. So you can see how much data is being used from which application and which IP it's connecting to. So right now, this video is playing in the background here, and we can see that Chrome has spit a little bit of data out at us. So the next section here under settings is monitor, and this is the Little Snitch monitor that I first showed you here. You can customize if you'd like it to appear when you hover over with the mouse or not, or if you'd like it to disappear automatically. So that's just on personal preference there. You can also change the color of the activity in the taskbar from a grayscale to a color. In the next menu here, you can create profiles for connecting to different networks. So if you'd like to choose different settings for different networks. Security and advanced have advanced rules in them for customizing the firewall. I would normally suggest to leave them alone. And then the update as well, I would suggest leave it alone. You can see here a little snitch will snitch on itself. And then the last tab here is registration. So that would be like your license code. This will run for 30 minutes on a demo, I believe, so you can definitely try it out first. Alright, so we've gone through some of the basics, setting up and settings with the app. Now I want to show you guys the rule list. This is where you can get really advanced with your firewall here. As you can see, every application, any notification you've ever received from Little Snitch will show up in here as a rule. If it was specified as a long-term rule, broken down to temporary rules, as you can see on the side list here on the right column, you can find a bunch of different rules that are broken down. You can see I have a couple invalid rules that I could clear out, applications that are no longer installed. You can customize the rules, so if you highlight one and you go to the edit rule option, you can see, for example, with Google Chrome here, we could change the connection to deny from allow, and if we were to run the application, it would not be able to access the internet. So this is also where profiling could come into place here. You can change different profiles for different networks using Little Snitch. If you're on a certain network where you don't want some applications to access the internet and vice versa. So really cool. If you see here, we can change it back, and then Chrome will have access to the internet again. So this is just a very basic example, you can get in depth with ports and specific connections and everything. So Lil Snitch is a really in-depth, powerful firewall for the macOS, and it's one of the reasons I really like the software here. So this is just another demo for you guys. If I set a video here to 1080p, you can measure the bandwidth that Chrome is downloading the video at, and you can see here I have a faster connection, so it downloads pretty quickly, but you can monitor the speed, and again, you can get the breakdown from all of the connections there. You can also resize the network monitor, so it's a really handy tool, easy to move around. And so there you guys go. That is Lil Snitch for macOS. I will finish the tutorial here showing Lil Snitch's built-in tutorial, which is pretty informative and launches when the app first launches. Since there's so much to Lil Snitch, I would definitely advise if you do download the app to take a good look at this. You can re-access it here just by going to the help and welcome to Lil Snitch. So what do you guys think? Definitely let me know in the comments below, and we'll see you guys again next time. Cheers.